Well, pregnant women are identified as one group most susceptible to swine flu. Dr. Ann Doll-Pollard is an OBGYN from St. Joseph Hospital in Breese, Illinois. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So is swine flu more dangerous for pregnant women?
The research suggests that it is. There was a study done this last spring where we looked at what happened with pregnant women who had swine flu or H1N1 flu. And they found that a third of pregnant women with H1N1 flu were hospitalized with complications from this flu. And 6% of the deaths from H1N1 flu have been in otherwise healthy pregnant women.
Well, you have brought along a list of some of the symptoms mm-hmm. of swine flu. We'll put these up on the screen and go over these for our viewers at home.
Okay, the symptoms are very similar to what we would see with the common flu. And those can include fever, cough, sore throat, body aches, muscle aches, headaches, fatigue, chills. And putting those in context, 97% of people with H1N1 flu will have a fever and 94% will have a cough. So those are the two most important things to look for.
Are there some symptoms that are different in the pregnant women?
It won't be different, but for some reason, they can be more severe in pregnant women. And why that is isn't completely understood. Pregnancy affects a woman's breathing or her lung function, and that could increase her risk for pneumonia. Also, the immune system's different during pregnancy, and that could increase risk.
So what about medications? Are there some that pregnant women should take or should stay away from?
The CDC and the American College of OBGYN have strongly recommended that pregnant women take antiviral medications like Tamiflu or Relenza during pregnancy. These medications are safe in all parts of pregnancy, and because the risk of serious illness is so high for pregnant women, the benefits of these really outweigh any potential risks.
What about the vaccine for swine flu?
That's the single most important thing a pregnant woman can do to protect herself and her unborn child.
And then what about the seasonal flu vaccine?
Pregnant women should get vaccinated for the seasonal flu as well, and their families should as well, too.
And are there any other medical challenges for pregnant women in regard to this?
There really aren't any other challenges, assuming you get vaccinated. I would still encourage women to report flu-like symptoms early, but again, the vaccine is our best defense.
Dr. Ann Doll-Pollard, thank you very much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.